Hello, my name is Steve Roberts. I'm the owner of Canine Top Performance in Reading, Massachusetts, located on 335 Main Street. Yeah, Canine Top Performance is a full-service dog training facility. We offer everything from basic obedience to behavior modification, dog aggression, people aggression, resource guarding, food aggression, whatever the case may be, full-service kennel. You can board your dog away when you're on vacation, anything like that. We also offer daycare, daycare with training, boarding with training, as well as your basic obedience all the way up to advanced obedience, which is more off-leash, and we also offer protection training. You know, if anybody is to ever break into your house, anything like that, you could use your dog as a tool if need be. Absolutely. You know, we're primarily using, you know, more power breeds like a German Shepherd, Dutch Shepherd, Belgian Malinois, yeah. Rottweilers, American Bulldogs, things like that. I have done it with Border Collies before. I have done it with Jack Russells before. Also, the Standard Poodle. So the first thing you guys had seen today is the agility. Agility is, some people will compete with it. I do it more just for fun. It's a very good confidence builder. You know, it teaches your dog to go up over obstacles. Most dogs tend to fear a lot of these things in the beginning. So what we end up doing is motivating the dog to go over the obstacles, and it forms a very good bond between you and your dog, because you're putting a dog in the situation where they're uncomfortable. You push them through it, they start to trust you more, and then you guys form a very good bond together. And it's, like I said, it's a very good confidence builder for the dogs. Anytime we have dogs that are nervous, fearful, doing agility builds confidence and makes things a lot easier for the dog to progress forward. The second thing you would saw is the obedience class. You know, this is more or less just teaching your dog the basics. Sit down, stay, come, heel. In my opinion, every single dog needs some type of obedience. You know, we need structure in the dog's life. We need to know how to command our dogs to listen. You know, even just if real life situation, your dog is to run to the street. You know, if they don't know how to listen, you're never gonna be able to recall them back. But most of the stuff is more just beginner, you know, teaching the sits and all the basic type of obedience here. The final thing you'll see today is the protection training. You know, this is done for people that want to have a dog that has an alert command, whether it's just a bark, you know, some type of a deterrent. Because most people, if they come up to your house and they hear a dog is there, you know, very, very hesitant to break in, you know. And then if it does come to the point where somebody is to attempt to come into your house, whatever the case is, this is why the dogs are here. You know, we train the dog to, you know, apprehend the suspect if need be. You know, absolutely. We always hope that our dog will never have to bite somebody, but in the world that we live in, you know, there are criminals, and unfortunately we have to, you know, get ourselves and our dogs trained just in case a serious situation is to come about. Yeah, we train with a lot of law enforcement, things like that as well, for apprehension training, the bite training, all that kind of stuff as well. I've done SWAT seminars, all that kind of stuff with some of the police dogs and the cop dogs, because what's good is they're now just incorporating with the SWAT team. The awards that you see around the office, they're all from my Dutch Shepherd named Fosco. I compete with him in a sport called PSA. We also do protection training for what we call sport dogs. You know, and they compete for obedience, agility, and protection. You know, so my dog has, luckily for me, done very well in this sport. You know, he is at the highest level. It's called the level 3. And there's only 14 dogs in the country that have ever passed. And he's passed once. He has to pass one more time, and he'll be the 15th dog in the country to ever pass this competition. The sport's been around for about 15 years, and I would be the youngest handler to ever achieve this PSA 3. Platz! Fuss! It's a combination of obedience, agility, control, and obviously protection. You know, and my dogs excelled very well. Some of the back trophies here, you might not see any of these ever again. The glass one there is a high obedience trophy. That means he got the highest obedience score out of all the dogs in the competition. And the one on the right side is a high protection. He got that one. He had the highest protection score out of all the dogs in the competition. You know, I got him at 8 weeks old. You know, we started doing the basic obedience right from then. Slowly started to incorporate the protection work. And, you know, the more you do it, you know, the more your dog will start to really excel. And the biggest thing about a dog is being consistent. I've been consistent, structured, and disciplined with him his whole entire life. You know, so now he's to the point where he is a off-leash, amazing obedience dog. I can do obedience demonstrations with him, as well as a protection dog. You know, he will do sport, but at the same time, I would consider him also an executive protection dog. He is a type of dog that he will also do sport obedience, but he is also, if somebody is to break into your house, he will apprehend them as well.